Hello and welcome to Folsom Field. I am Matt Smith for 5280 Sports Network. Thank you very much for tuning in. Well, in the 94th season of football at Folsom Field, the Colorado Buffaloes started it off with a bang, advancing to 2-0 in 2017 as they knock off the Texas State Bobcats 37-3 today and bounce back from somewhat of a lackluster first half to really close the door in that second half of play. In the first half, it was more of the same from what we saw from Colorado against Colorado State last week, especially from Steven Montez in that second half. Struggling to go through his progressions, missed a lot of open receivers, despite the fact that Colorado took a 14-0 lead into halftime. Even Montez after the game saying that he has a lot of improvement to do. He is escaping the pocket too early right now, which hangs out his offensive line to dry, really. And I think, honestly, I was saying this on Twitter during the game, that I think that's part of the reason why the offensive line for Colorado, so many people think that they're struggling so much right now, is because Montez, quite frankly, hadn't been making the best decisions with the football through the last three or so quarters up until the second half. Then when the second half came, Montez really settled down. He was poised. I liked what I saw from him. But in that first half, part of it with that offensive line is the fact that they are without their sixth-year left tackle in Jeremy Irwin. He, what seems to have been, along with George Frazier, was serving a two-game suspension for the first two games of this season. After the game, Coach McIntyre saying that they both will return next week against Northern Colorado. But first, I think it was the third drive of the game, Josh Kaiser was removed and Isaac Miller was inserted at that left tackle position. I spoke to Clayton Adams on Monday, who is the offensive line coach. He was not pleased with their performance last week against Colorado State. He said that if these guys can't improve, they will find other players who can step up and do so and actually step in and make some plays. Today we saw Isaac Miller have a very good performance, considering he came in a somewhat of a tough situation for him, just not preparing as the starter. But he is one of the guys that we had heard in the offseason deserved time with the ones. And McIntyre after the game saying that we found ourselves a backup tackle, which is good news for the Buffs. But in that first half, they really tried to run the ball quite a bit at the outset. Phil in this game, 26 carries, 87 yards, only averaged 3.3 yards a carry, which is very uncharacteristic of him. No carries over 10 yards for Phil Lindsay. I think in the game altogether, the Buffalo's first team offense was 4 of 12 on third down conversions. At the end of that first quarter, of course, the Isaiah Oliver fumble, which led to a Laviska Shenault touchdown on a 55-yard scoop and score, was some foolishness turned into brilliance, which is just part of the game of football. Isaiah Oliver should have definitely gone down on that punt return, tried to make something out of nothing. Laviska Shenault, the true freshman, picks it up, the scoop and score. I believe just the 15th player in CU history to score a touchdown on their first collegiate touch. This year in my postgame videos, we're going to try something a little different. Matt's moment of the game that really changed the momentum and led to the Buffalo's victory was the Bryce Bobo 28-yard catch that led to that Steven Montez 2-yard touchdown after Shea Fields with a big chunk play to start that drive off. Bobo twisting a la the catch he made last year at Oregon that landed him in SportsCenter's top 10. I would imagine we'll see that here a little later on tonight. That was definitely the moment that swayed this. The crowd got back involved. They woke up. It was an early kickoff. Then in the second half, Colorado and Texas State exchanged field goals. And then after that, the Buffaloes really rolled. It was the Isaiah Oliver interception that led to the Buffaloes' first touchdown of the second half. An outstanding play by Oliver, returns it 41 yards, and then the Buffaloes would capitalize on that turnover, which is something that we have not seen this Buffs team really do yet in 2017. It's very early, but it was a great early sign that they were able to take that moment and capitalize on it with a Phil Lindsay 7-yard touchdown. Later, just the next drive in back-to-back drives, Bryce Bobo would catch a touchdown. The Buffaloes then would pretty much roll from there on out. Something else we're going to do differently in the videos this year, stars of the game. Defensively first, Leo Jackson at that pass rusher position with his hand in the ground. They moved him around tonight. Well, he feasted on Damian Williams, that's Texas State's opposing quarterback. 3 sacks tonight, 5 total tackles. Isaiah Oliver is another star tonight. Just 1 tackle, but a huge interception. And really, Isaiah's showing that he's becoming one of the nation's elite corners. I hope you can all see that now. He has really developed into a special player. In fact, after the game, Coach McIntyre saying that he doesn't believe he can be a good corner. He doesn't believe he can be a special corner. He believes he can be a phenomenal corner. This is very high praise from a guy who has tons of experience working with defensive backs throughout his career. Isaiah Oliver showing great things here through these first 2 games. And the other player who had a very solid return to the football team last week against TXSU is Evan Worthington on the defensive side. 9 total tackles, 2 tackles for loss, and 1 pass breakup. Flashing athleticism. And this is a guy who, before the season in fall camp, I told you, keep an eye out for Evan Worthington and what he can do this season. He's totally changed his mentality. He's a different person. And Coach McIntyre in the post game saying that it's pretty cool when you can watch guys grow up like that, become kids to men. And that's what he's seeing right now with Evan Worthington. And now on to the offensive stars of the game. Shea Fields, 5 catches, 110 yards, no touchdowns, but should have had at least 2 if Steven Montez doesn't underthrow him on a couple of big plays, maybe even a 3rd. I thought Shea was outstanding today and last week. He's really primed for a big senior season. His senior running mate, Bryce Bobo, also a star of the game. 7 catches, 75 yards, and a second half touchdown. He also had my Matt's moment of the game. I thought that that was a huge turning point in this contest. And then the other star of the game on the offensive end, second half Steven Montez. First half Steven Montez did not earn a star, but the second half one did. 12 of 18 in the second half for 178 yards and a touchdown. I thought he was efficient. He stayed in the pocket, made some good decisions with the football, and I thought he, even in the running game, had a couple of really nice plays out of the read option. I thought the poise that we saw him play with in the second half was really what maybe we'd see him play with more consistently this season. We'll see if that just needs to take a couple of games to develop, but I thought that that was impressive from Steven specifically. In the kicking game, what I really liked was the fact that the Buffs may have now finally found themselves somebody that they don't have to bite their fingernails on every field goal. James Stefano, the 30-year-old former professional soccer player from Australia, 4 of 5 now on the season. Very impressed with what I saw from him today. 3 of 3 in this game, and each of his kicks had the height, they had plenty of power, and I think that with that maturity, all of course being 30, that maybe things will start to click for him a little faster, especially since he played professional soccer already. So if he can become somebody that the Buffs can rely on, which early indications are maybe he can be that guy, that would be a huge step in the right direction for this Colorado kicking unit. My final star of the game goes to Davis Price, the other kicker who does the kicking off. Nothing but touchbacks. The leg has looked great this season in 2 games. I know it's early, but if the Buffaloes can find that consistency from not only Stefano, but Price as well, it only spells good news for the Buffaloes moving forward. A 2-0 start to 2017. Next week, the Buffs will face off against the University of Northern Colorado. UNC did not play this weekend, as their game against the University of Florida that was scheduled for this weekend was actually canceled due to Hurricane Irma. So the Bears will come in next week, plenty well rested, and I can guarantee you they watched every minute of that football game today. 2-0 start for the Buffs in 2017. Solid stuff. We'll see if they can progress. Make sure you stay tuned to 5280 Sports Network for all your Buffs coverage. I am Matt Smith. Thanks for tuning in.